doing a planner class that's kind of the basics and beginning and planning. So if you just got a new planner for the holidays and you're ready to hit the ground running in the new year, this is a class that you're definitely going to want to check out. It's at the same time, again, 3 p.m. Central Time. So be sure to go online, michaels.com/classes, and sign up for that one as well. So we've got a lot to cover. I'll give it just a minute and then we can go more into it. Also wanted to let you know that if you miss any of this class, it will be available online on michaels.com/classes, and you can see the pre-recorded ones. You can also check out all of the different videos from your Happy Planner mentors that they've been doing with Michaels. So there's a lot of planner content already out there. So be sure to check out those replays. All righty. Well, let's go ahead and get started. I'm going to go ahead and flip it over. Let's see. Let me turn the lights on. Here we go. Okay. When we're planning, we're typically, this is the stickers we think of. These are fantastic. We love these sticker books. But did you guys know that me and my big ideas, the Happy Planner, makes a ton of amazing other stickers that are available. These Mambi sticks, again, me and my big ideas, are letter stickers, and they come in every possible, you know, font, color, design that you can think of. Can you tell I love them? Like, I have quite the extensive collection. And so they're so much fun, and just, you can really customize and create a ton of different things with these stickers. They also have, I grabbed some of these while I was at Michael's. They have some really fun decorated ones, and they're themed. So I grabbed a birthday one, I've grabbed the beach one. I've actually used these many times, both in my planner and for projects. So we'll kind of show some of these as well. So again, there's just so many options. I think the typical thing that people think of when we're doing, you know, these kind of sticker letters, let me grab one, is creating a banner and that sort of thing. But you guys, there's so much more you can do with these. So what we're going to do is we're going to kind of talk about using them in our planners and also using them to create things for our planners, create decor, and so much more. First up, I'm going to show you how, this is an old planner. I think this one's from 2017 or 18. I was just going to show you a couple examples of how I used mambiSTICKS in actual planning. Oh, it's 2017. This is an old one, guys. A lot of times we think of these stickers that fit perfectly in our planner, and they're beautiful and they're perfect, but sometimes it's really fun to play with scale and add a lot of interest to your planner. And like, I use these numbers to kind of create the countdown, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 for New Year's. And it really adds a lot of visual interest, and it's just fun. I also use this big one on a sheet of acetate that I punched so that I could add more photos and things into my planner. So again, think scale, think visual interest. It's just a lot of fun to add some of these larger stickers. I think for this one, I just use a simple number 13 for my daughter's birthday, as well as these mambiSTICKS. These are the candles that were from the birthday stickers. So it's just, again, a new element that's fun that you can add in. Also got this one. I love adding large graphic words like this into my planner. So this one was cheer, and I have all her pictures around it. This was just so much fun. It just ties the whole page together. Again, I just use my regular stickers, but then adding these sticker letters really kind of takes it up a notch. So that is just an example of using these in your planner, because I mean, we all use obviously stickers in our planner, but we don't always use those different scales. So now let's get looking at some other ways we can use mambiSTICKS. Alrighty. So for this one, I grabbed out, I mean, how perfect is this for us? I mean, come on. So this is the I'm a Happy Planner, and it's got tons and tons of options and stickers in here that you can use. You can put these in your planner and that's great, but I wanted to kind of create something fun with it as well that I can use and continue to reuse in my planner. So we're all familiar with these. This is actually just the acetate that comes on your planner with the little hang tag. I pulled these out of my recycle bin. You guys don't throw these away. I cut it down and they're already pre-punched and ready to go. And I'm going to create a divider with these. I mean, this is, again, this is a fast and simple project. So all I'm going to do, let's take a look. I'm literally going to grab this sticker. Now this one, I love my planner. And I use this is like a clay tool or paper piercer. I use these all the time when I'm picking up stickers. It just makes it so much easier. Alrighty, and I'm just going to kind of visually center it. And there, I mean, guys, so easy. And now I have a quick divider for my planner. I'm gonna put it in a week here. So I can find where I'm at in my planner. If you've got extra pages in your planner and you know you want to do that, you could even add some fun ribbon. I've put a punch in it before, but I mean, how simple and fun. And you can customize them. You can put your name. You can do all kinds of things. Look, there's like another one. Let's see. Here's one. Just living my best planner life. I'm gonna put this one on the small one. A lot of times too, if you've got different sections in your planner that you want to, like you might have all of your fitness planning or something in the back or note paper in the back, you can have dividers that can kind of separate the different sections. I'm just gonna pretend there's a section here. I mean, that was a 2 second craft and we've got a really cute custom divider for our planners. That's one of the things I love about these mambiSTICKS. There's just tons of options and tons of things that you can create. Another, let's take a look, thing, let's do this first, is covers. I always love the designs that the Happy Planner has on theirs, obviously. But sometimes you might want to make a custom cover to kind of fit maybe something that you love. And there's so many different amazing scrapbook papers at Michael's you can get in the, there's packs that they have, which are awesome, different themes, but you can also get some of the loose scrapbook paper that they have there as well. So you can kind of find something that fits your style. I love this, and I love these iridescent letters as well. So I'm going to create a custom planner. And again, I'm going to keep it really easy. So I'm just going to, I took an existing one that I've got, and you'll notice that your lamination always goes on the out, like above and beyond, you know, your paper. So I'm going to kind of measure where the actual paper is, not where the lamination is. So I'm going to do this on the reverse side. So when I cut it, let me see, I'm gonna make it over here. I like this section of the paper. So again, this is so easy. I'm just gonna use a pen and mark it and then grab my paper trimmer. So you can measure it, obviously, but I am eyeballing this. So I'm gonna put a little mark right here. And again, this is on the reverse side. And that's another wonderful thing about the double-sided paper, is it's perfect for creating a cover, because then you're going to have something that coordinates on the inside of your planner. So if it's a solid piece, you could always take two pieces of scrapbook paper and double them up. Okay, so now I've got my dimensions, and I love these Fiskar cutters. So they make everything so easy and simple, especially for me, because I cannot cut a straight line. Like I try, but it's just not good. Alrighty, so I've got this, and I'll just cut this section off. I hope I did that in the right direction. And then I'm going to cut here, and I'm just lining up my little mark. All right, so now I've got the front of my cover. If you look at the Happy Planner covers, you'll notice that they're rounded. The edges are rounded. So in order to keep it kind of like that same design and style and give it like a nicer feel, make sure you round those corners. There's paper rounders. If you were a scrapbooker, you probably have one handy, but they still have these at Michael's. I love to use these. It just gives it a finished look. There we go. Alrighty, so you can really customize this with any, you know, any of these stickers. I love this, and I think I just want to do my initial, like bold in the middle. I just think this is so pretty. And what I was doing when I went to look at it, let's see. I pulled off this M. Let me do this really quick. And, you know, you could easily, you know, I could put this on here and be done with my spread. But when I was doing that, I saw this. And a lot of times there's negative space, an option that you need to look at when you're doing any stickers, because I fell in love with this. So all I'm gonna do is actually use the negative space on my cover. And you can just easily trim around. I know I had run out of numbers to do my little countdown for the 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 this year. And so this is a technique that I used as well in my planner. I think the negative space really adds to like a different design element. So it's a lot of fun. You don't have to use stickers only the way they were designed. This is the throwaway extra, but I actually love it. So I'm just going to cut really close to the edge. I might not have it perfect for this, but let's keep going. And then I'm going to put this down. Now I could add my full name. With mambiSTICKS, there's tons of options of size. So you could do a really graphic big one. You could do small. The possibilities are endless of what you can create. So based on your, you know, your style, and I think that's what I love. We can all use different, you know, letters and mambiSTICKS and create really custom things for ourselves without, you know, this is a craft that takes a few minutes versus, you know, like if you're using a cutting machine or something. Not all of us have those, but you can create really custom and cool things just from using these fun sticker letters. All righty.
While you're doing that, I want to let everyone know that the chat is open. So if they want to open up their chat, if they have any questions, you can actually place them in the chat and we can answer them from there.
Yes, wonderful, thank you. If you've got questions, if you want to talk amongst yourselves and talk, definitely use that chat. And you can also, if you, there's a Q&A button. If there's a question that you want to ask me at the end, we can go over those as well. So be sure to use the chat and the Q&A buttons as well. All righty, so I'm just gonna lay this kind of in the middle here. And there we go. Now I've got a really pretty custom design that, yes, this M would have been great, but I just really love the way that this is kind of more minimal. And then I'm gonna save this M. Gotta save all the letters, save the stickers, and I'll use it again at another time. But, and then all you need to do is run this through your laminator, punch it, and then you can have a new custom cover. Now, if you don't want to laminate and you don't want to create, you know, actually have to make your cover, I know a lot of times, like I'll get a cover and I've got a planner, and I love this planner, but because I just loved the insides. I loved the way I'm using this for journaling. Let me find it. So I'm writing every day like a sentence. So I love this planner, but the cover just isn't me, right? It's very easy to kind of flip it and make a whole new cover for yourself. So I actually liked the inside with the fun typed letters. So what I did is I took the cover off. I'm gonna take this one off, right? I just take the back cover, which says Live Creatively, which is perfect. Flip it around to the front and then use this on the back. So now I've got a completely different cover for my planner that is more me. So I loved this, but you can customize it, you guys, with these Mambi sticks. You can add your name. You can add the date. You could add, what I want to do is add the year to this. So I'm going to grab, I loved these. I think they really go. The scale is really big, and that's actually what I wanted for this mini. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put 2021 on here. So again, you can customize your planner without having to like really recreate anything. So I'm going to grab this too. Again, I'm using, this is really for, I guess, now they use them for clay. I use it to move my stickers. So I'm going to put a 2 here and a 0. And again, you can pick any fonts, any colors, whatever you like. So I'm going to put 20. And then let's see, 21. So I'm going to see where I put this. And actually, I want it to kind of, I think I'm going to have it over. See, now it just comes down to design choice. Do I want it here? Or do I want it here? I think I want to move it. 20. 21. And again, you could put your initial, you could put, let me use the yellow one. Why not? Change it up. There we go. So now I've got a custom cover that fits me and fits my style more. So again, you don't have to create a full new cover. You can grab any of your Mambi sticks. These are clear. If you want it to pop out more, I just wanted it kind of subtle. You could use some of the solid ones. There's so many different designs and choices. So it's really what you want. Another tip that I suggest is as you are using them, go ahead and mark them off. Use the back kind of like a key. So I'm going to go ahead and I use this one, this one, this one, and this one. That way, later when you're going to do a project, you don't get halfway with your letters and you've written like half the name out and you're like, uh-oh, I've run out of stickers. I can't finish my project. This way you'll know what you've got. And you can make sure that you either pick up another pack or come up with a different plan. So that's just a tip that I suggest when you are using these Mambi sticks. That way you don't back yourself into a corner when you're creating. All right. So now we've created a cover. We've created dividers. And so we've done a lot of stuff with our planners. But there are so many other things, you guys, that we can create with these Mambi sticks. So now we're going to get kind of into some more kind of decor memory things and things that will just help you around the house. So first up, again, I'm using these Mambi sticks that were the planner, the Happy Planner one. And we are going to make you can make a door tag. I know at Michael's, they sell the cute foam door tags, but for me, I wanted to create like a little sign that I can hang on my door so my whole family knows when I am planning and they know not to come in and bug me, right? You could also create a sign, like a Zoom sign, like if you've got a meeting, you could use any of these Mambi sticks and kind of create something. But for me, I wanted to create a planning in progress. So again, so easy. This is just some like a mat board. You can pick up any kind of hard cardstock or mat board, anything you want. I could add some discs to it if I wanted. Let's do that. And I'm actually going to kind of cut some of these apart so I can get different looks. Whoops. We can put that there. I could put this little cluster. I could add one. So don't be afraid. Don't be afraid to cut your stickers. It's okay. I know a lot of times like, well, that's not how the sticker is and it doesn't fit. That's okay. You can create it however you want. I think a lot of times we're scared to cut things up, but go for it. Change it up. Make it different. All right, I'm going to put this one. Actually, I'm going to put it here. You can even have it come off the page and actually cut the edges off just like that. All righty. And I think I'm just going to use this little two cluster in this bottom corner. Okay. And I'm going to kind of do the same thing right here. So now I've got a really simple, this is again, just a quick and easy thing that you can create. Gotta save that last disc. I don't know if you guys are like me, but I always save all the X's. All right. And then, I mean, you can add ribbon. You could poke holes. If you do have a door hanger, you're pretty much done. But I wanted to do kind of like a little hanging tag that I can put on the door. You could even add some Happy Planner discs as well. Oh, I'm just gonna grab, I'm grabbing crazy tape just to show you. This is like, this is not the tape you would use, but this is what was in front of me and I'm just gonna go for it. Alrighty, so all you need to, you could use a glue gun as well. Or sandwich it in. That's a good idea. You could actually have another mat board. I could create something different on this side and sandwich it. And then I've got two options that I can hang on the doorknob like I'm planning, or you know, whatever I wanted to say, or Zoom call or anything like that. So this is just something super fast and simple that you can create for your house. All right. So next up is, I am really big on, I love frames. You guys, if you watched my other Michael's class for the Christmas decor with your stickers, you guys, these frames are amazing. They come in a pack of three, and I want for the 8x8s, and the 5x7s, I believe, come in a pack of four. And right now they are buy one, get one half, and these are awesome. I love, what I really love about them is, I don't know if you can see right there, they've got dimension to them. So the glass is not right up against the backing. So what I love to do is play with that. Again, I'm all about playing with negative space. I love to either add stuff inside between the glass, or you can put stuff on the glass and kind of create that shadow effect. So I love using these. And the thing is they come in so many different colors. There's white, black, red, I mean, a ton of different options. I love the gold because I feel like it just has like such a pretty, elegant look, and it works great for the decor in my craft room and in my house. So I think these are awesome. For this project, this one is crazy fast and easy and just a lot of fun. So first off, you can grab scrapbook paper. So what I do, I'm gonna take the back off of this one. Really, really simple here. Okay, so taking the back off. And again, this is the little insert that takes the, that keeps that kind of distance from your background paper. If you wanted your paper right up against it, you could take this off and put it right up against it. But for me, the negative space is one of my very favorite things. Okay, so I found some scrapbook paper that I really liked, and it went with the decor in my planner room. So I went with this. And again, when you've got it in there, you've got that space where it's not right up against the glass. And then I could add some sticker letters to here and move on. What I thought would be kind of fun is, let me pop this back out, playing with this negative space. I just grabbed some of my planner discs that I've got. So I'm just going to, different size gold discs. I've got big ones, little ones. And again, I'm creating decor for my planner room. You could put, I mean, you could do so many things. I did, you know, fake snow when it was Christmas, where you could put pom-poms, or, you know, they have tons of filler. And it's like vase filler options at Michael's that you can put in there. I mean, gems, anything you want. Now, I just did it where I wanted them kind of loose at the bottom. So like this. And then I'm just going to add, got some stickers picked out. I went ahead and used the gold. And I'm just going to write plan on it. This is a simple, easy decor that I can use in my planner room. I mean, normally I would probably make sure this is perfectly straight. But for you guys, I'm going to, if I did that, you guys, right now, it would be, we'd be here a long time. Because I like hold my breath. I don't know if you guys do it, but as you're putting stickers down, I hold my breath just to make sure. Okay. And then, so I'm just going to put plan. And I don't know if you can tell, it's already got dimension to it. Whoops, that's a little low. I'm probably doing it crooked, but that's okay. If you were doing it, what I would suggest to make sure that your stickers are straight, grab a ruler, and all you have to do is line them up on the edge of the ruler. And then that way you can take your word over, center it, and put them on. We'll do that technique for one of, another one of these over here. Okay. And so now I've got this dimension to it, and I can put this like in my planner room. And then I've got really cute decor. And again, this one looks kind of like, I'd say like elegant. If you want fun, bright, you can use rainbow colors, rainbow discs in there, or don't even have the disc and just have plan, anything you want. This one to me though, I thought would be perfect for my decor. So again, really easy and simple, but kind of has a lot of impact. And when you see it, I know these lights, when you see it in person and on a wall, that dimension, see the shadow, really makes it pop. So that is another example of something that you can easily create with mambiSTICKS in for your home. All right. This is one that I have been kind of eyeballing that I wanted to try. So we're going to try it together. This is an acrylic frame. They've got a bunch of acrylic signs now at Michael's. And I just thought these things were super cool. And I've seen them used on Instagram where people, like for weddings or whatever, they'll make this gorgeous sign and they'll hand letter beautiful, beautiful things on it. And you guys, I wish I could do that. I wish I could bust out the paint and hand letter, but it's just not my forte. I'm gonna practice it. I'm gonna learn. But right now, it's not happening. But I know I can create something pretty. And this has a whole different look. It's like a modern look. And I can create something fun and pretty with my mambiSTICKS. So. And we could, okay, so I've got this sign. And what I wanted to do, I'm gonna kind of put on this paper so you can see it better, is I wanted to create one of those Wi-Fi passwords. When you've got a guest coming over, you can put it in their room. I know we're not having a lot of guests right now, but I am confident at some point in 2021, we will, right? So what I wanted to do here was kind of create a sign that I, acrylic sign that I can easily change out the password for when people come over. I've seen a bunch of these like custom made, and I think they're gorgeous, but I thought with the acrylic and kind of keeping it modern, it would be a lot of fun. So I already pulled off the letters and I wanted to use a white kind of, actually I'm gonna start with password, white letters, and I'm gonna keep it right here. Now, right now it's harder to see. I've got a piece of paper behind it. I probably should add a color paper on there. But what I'm planning to do is add an element, and I'm making these just kind of bounce up and down. They're not perfect. This particular mambiSTICK, what I loved about it is each of the letters, oops, was a little bit different. You'll notice these two S's are not exactly the same. So I kind of thought that was a lot of fun. It kind of adds some visual interest to it, almost makes it look like it was handmade versus where every single letter is the same. And again, that's just a different look. A lot of times, like with that last project, we wouldn't want, too much variation. It needed to be kind of modern. So again, you can find letters that match your style. And I know my style changes depending on the project, but, and some of these letters were loopy, some of them were straight, and I chose a lot more of the straighter versions. But I love that it gives you that kind of different look. So now I'm going to put Wi-Fi. I'm trying to decide if I want to, I actually might have it over here. I'm going to put it right here. I want it more aligned on the side versus centered in the middle. And again, just a choice, just a kind of design choice. Alrighty. So I've got Wi-Fi password. And then what I thought would be fun, I just grabbed some old craft paint that I've got. And you guys, Michaels has, every time I walk into the paint aisle, I get like completely, like I decide I need all the colors. They have beautiful, beautiful colors and options. What I'm going to do is paint on the reverse side. Let's see how this works, guys. And I'm just going to, I chose like a kind of coppery metallic. And I'm just going to kind of highlight over the colors. And you can, again, pick colors that match your house. You don't have to use one color. You could use a bunch of colors, just whatever works for your decor. And let's just see how this looks. And again, it's not, so I will probably add a little bit more, but you see how it kind of gives, it makes those letters pop off. I would probably do it a little thicker to not have the brush strokes, but again, it really just depends on the look that you want. So I'm gonna kind of put that here. All right, and then you can use a dry erase marker and change that out. You can just write on here, whatever it is, X, Y, Z. And then you've got a cute Wi-Fi password sign that you can have when people come over in the future, right? In the future. And again, you could change this out. I could use, there's amazing ribbons, or I could do just some pretty chain that matches this color. But I mean, the possibilities are endless. And yours can look completely different. You can have all very straight letters. Just so many options that you can do and create. So I'm going to move this one aside. I'm going to kind of, I need to flip it over and let it dry. Look what I've done. And we'll move that and go on to another project. I'm just whipping through these, you guys, but there's so many things you can create and so many different looks that I wanted to be able to share as many as I could in my 1 hour that I've got with you guys. So next up is something, again, I'm basically creating a bunch of things that I've always wanted. So I went to Michael's, and they have a bunch of these framed wood. They've got some that have grooves, some that are stained, some that are solid wood like this. I picked up this one because I always love those custom signs, but I don't necessarily love the price, and I've always wanted one, but I thought, you know what? I can create my own, kind of give that same visual look with mambiSTICKS. So what I did is I took this framed wood board, and if you are a carpenter and you can create your own, awesome. That is not my talent or my wheelhouse. So I bought this one and I just painted it. So I painted it white in the middle and black on the edges. I just wanted like a simple modern look for this. So again, craft paint, you guys. I bought they have a CraftSmart kit that has, I don't even know how many paints in it. I just bought the whole thing because it was awesome. So I just used craft paint, acrylic craft paint. And then I decided I was going to do one of those cool kind of the last name signs. And I wanted it to be really bold. So I've cut out my letters just so I can actually see how I'm going to place them. This is just my last name. Again, my last name is really short, so I used the biggest letters I could find. But there's, again, so many fonts, so many sizes, so many different looks you can do. So let's take a look. Alrighty. So that'll fit if I just kind of barely space them apart. So what I want to do is kind of create one of these signs. When I'm sticking down this many letters, it's kind of hard to keep these straight. So what I did is I grabbed some of the transfer tape that you use for your Cricut or your Silhouette. And I'm going to use this to help me transfer these letters over. And again, there are so many different, like this one works for my last name, but they have huge boards and just like, I mean, those really cool oversized ones. I'd love to get one of those like for my laundry room. I don't know if you've seen those, like where you can put wash and fold. You could even use some of those mambiSTICKS stickers. I mean, they're just, guys, that's what I love about this is it can be perfect for you. You know, like you can create just about anything. I'm going to actually use the edge of this to kind of secure it for a second. So I'm going to grab this transfer tape. We're going to experiment together, you guys. All right. I'm going to kind of put this here and I'm going to hold it down with this. All righty. So I'm going to grab my letter. So when you're using transfer tape, I think what I'm going to do is kind of take the top half off here. Actually, I'm gonna take the whole thing off. We are going for it. I was gonna say you can do it to where you don't take the full letter off. You take part of it off, but you know what? We're going for it. And you're gonna wanna put it upside down. So I'm going to put this right perfect on this line. In fact, I think I might do it higher up so it doesn't cover my whole letter. And I'm just gonna go, the grid kind of helps you place it and it's gonna help me kind of keep this straight. So I've got my Y.
Hey, Meryl.
Yes.
Before you put your S down, they're letting you know that your S is upside down.
Oh, thanks guys.
And look. Then while you're doing that as well, they're trying to figure out the tool that you were using.
Oh, this one? But,
yes.
Okay,
what type of tool is that?
This is a paper piercer, is the original like scrapbooking name. They are now, I want to say over with the clay, all the like clay items, people use them to poke the holes in the clay. So that I use it a lot of times to lift and place stickers. It just helps me. So I love using it for that. So let me see, let me make sure I'm going to do this right. Now my R needs to go over here. See, I would have mirror image, you guys. I would have put it on, flipped it over, and it would have been the wrong way. Okay. So yeah, they're over in now the clay crafting aisle. I used to be able to find those over in the paper crafting section. It was actually, I think, originally for quilling, paper quilling. And again, I'm going fast right now. So normally I would count the blocks and make sure that, you know, I've got it kind of covered with the spacing. But if I do that, you guys, I'll be here 100 years. And I know you guys are like, let's see what you're doing. Let's go. So I'm going to just kind of go ahead. I probably didn't need this big of a sheet of this long. Oops, I can tell my Y is a little higher. Off. See, and then what it helps that transfer tape, I can pull the sticker off without really worrying about ripping it. So I'm going to put that. And then now I'm on my S. And you guys, let's make sure I do it the right way. Okay. Thanks for letting me know it was upside down. I would look at it later and be like, wait a minute. What's wrong with that? Okay. And then we're going to just place the S. Right here. There we go. Okay. So now I've got my transfer tape. I've got my letters and they're all hopefully lined up. And I'm just going to kind of, right now, I'm just going to visually look. If I was making this sign, you know, I would make sure that it is, you know, straight. For right now, we're going for it, guys. So you use that transfer tape to kind of place it down. I'm going to place the bottom pieces first and then tap the top. Okay, and then I'm going to slowly pull the transfer tape away. If you've ever used vinyl, it's like using it for vinyl. But when you're using really large oversized stickers, I definitely recommend using some kind of transfer tape, because trying to lay all of these letters down at once can get really tricky. And maybe, you know, you might be more talented than I am. I cannot do it. I cannot get those on straight. Oh, my R wasn't tapped down. Alrighty, let's, oh, see, stay down. I didn't lay it flat first. This one's wanting to give me trouble. I don't think I laid it down all the way. So I'm just gonna, there we go. Okay, so now I've got a really pretty sign. And then you can even add to it, you could add like those, you know, established and put the year, and you could do all kinds of things. I was just gonna do like the Reyes family. And this again, I can't hand letter like that. If I could paint this, I would, but that's just, it is not in my wheelhouse. So I actually laid these and I overlapped them. If you're doing like a cursive-y font and you overlap them, it actually makes it really easy, because when you take them off, they're already together. So I'm gonna just kind of place this right here. Now I've got that. Again, now this looks like I've got a custom-made sign when it's on the wall. I could like add ribbon. I could add, you know, just about anything. For me and the look I was going for, I wanted it very minimal. So now I've got my family word. Again, another thing I like about this tool is my fingers aren't in the way. I can see where I place it. So I might put this one, let's see, right about here. So I'm just going to move my tool. And the good thing about sticker letters is if I don't like it, I can move it. I mean, I'm not married to this. I can move it around. Like my S is crooked, I can fix that. So again, a really fast and easy thing you can do, customize the colors, customize the letters, the fonts, and you've got something that you can put on your wall that's really tailored for you and your looks. So the letters, let's see, I think somebody asked what letters I need for those. That's the thing about the mambiSTICKS, you guys. Well, hello, look at my collection, this is crazy. Is there so many options? This is the one I used for the Wi-Fi. Let's see if it's got a name on here. It's just got numbers. So really, if you go down the scrapbook aisle, just find ones that match your look. This was the one for the script. When you look at first, it doesn't look, you know, like, it just looks like letters and it might look strange together. But when you overlap them, it really looks like script. It's got the connecting swooshes. You can cut them if you need to, anything you want. So these are really pretty. I love these. And you get so many of the letters. So it's really awesome. But like there's brights, there's, you know, I mean, just about any look you can think of, you can do mambiSTICKS. So this is the big ones that I used. So I use these to create the Reyes part, but I mean, I could use a type. I could do my established and then the numbers with like this kind of font. There's glitter letters. I've got foil, I've got rose gold, gold, silver, iridescent. These are sparkly, but there's just so many options. You can really customize and create a bunch of really cool things for your home and for your, that you don't have to like, you know, spend a ton of time on. So here's something. This one is huge. This is one of those big ones. I could use this to create one of those signs. This is really, really big. I'm going to paint the edges. But let me see if I can show you guys what it is. I'm going to try to get this around. Whoops. So this is a chalkboard and it comes already ready to go. It's got the hanging pieces. If you want to hang it, whether it's vertical or horizontal, it's already got the hanging pieces ready to go for you. So this one, we're all planners, right? I thought it'd be really fun to create a chalkboard like menu. So I use those kind of menu, those chalkboard looking letters and wrote out menu. And then I'm gonna have the days of the week. Let me check how we're doing. We're running low on time. So what I would do is I would take this off and put the menu across the top. And then I was gonna put the days of the week going down the side. I'll just grab an M just to give you an example. What I would do is measure, oh my goodness, measure out and find the center and then use, you know, make sure my letters are centered. But if I've got that across the top, all you need to do to create a custom menu is put, and it looks like you created, you know, chalk art. And this, I'm telling you, I don't have the lettering talent, but I mean, look how fast and easy this is. I'm not having to, you know, recreate the wheel. And then once you've got all of your letters down, I've got all the days of the week. This is something that you can change out every week. Got menu at the top, got the days of the week. I can get chalk and we can write out, what are we eating? So nobody's asked, and hang this up in the kitchen, and no one's asking, hey, what's for dinner or whatever. And you can also plan your meals this way, and change it every week. They even sell chalk markers now. You don't even have to use actual chalk. You can write it on here and then clean it off every week, but your chalk art is safe and it will not go anywhere. So you can customize it again to your decor. You can make this silver, you can make it metallic, you could make it, you could stain it. Whatever works for your decor, that's what I love about all of these really fun pieces that they have at Michael's right now. So just wanted to make sure you guys, you know we love mambiSTICKS, we love stickers, we love using them in our planners, right? We love these. I'll show you another really fast. I know we're running pretty low on time, but get them out of your planner. Start creating some other things. This is something that I created. Let me see, it's got like, with these, maybe these beach ones. I just used a mason jar. I put take me to the beach. We collect sand from every beach that we go to. So this is a Port A for Port Aransas. It's called Port A here in Texas. And I've got a picture on the inside with a beach day sticker on it. It's kind of hard for me to show it here. And then I've got the sand that we collected in a shell that day from the beach. And this is something that can sit on my dresser. And it's, so it's both a memory, but it's also something fun and pretty to look at as well. And it's different than just a regular frame. I mean, I could use one of those really cool square frames and, you know, put the sand in that and have a photo, but this is just something that's fun. And since we go to different beaches, I can have jars and different sizes, like for all of the different beaches that we go to, we could do a small jar with a mini picture, or the picture could go on top. You could have the sand inside. So there's, and you can kind of create like a fun collection. So really it just depends, I mean, on your imagination and what you guys want to do with these. But I encourage you to go through your sticker stash and start thinking of different ways that you can utilize your mambiSTICKS and all of your different items to create some fun home decor. Let me move this over and see if we've got, I know I went fast, and I know I'm gonna turn this off so we can go forward facing. Alrighty. I know I went quick there, but if anybody's got any questions.
I have questions for you.
Okay. I know I went quick and I was so excited and wanted to show you guys all of the projects that I created, but yeah, I'd love to get some questions.
Okay. I looked up the corner punch you were using, and if you want to hold that up real quick, I'll tell the number on that. Okay, that's what the one you have, but there's one online at Michael's.
There's different colors, yeah.
Right, it's 101-507-94, and that's just a punch that you can buy in the punch area. So it's going to be in the paper crafting department, and if you don't get the number written down, you can Google it. You can, you know, you can put it in the search at michaels.com. It's called a corner punch, and that's what she used there.
Yes.
When you were making dividers,
yes.
What did you use? So can you go back over that real quick?
Sure thing.
Where did you get the clear divider?
I'm gonna find all my supplies. Where did I stash that when I was talking? What I used for that was the little hang tag. It's under here. Where'd it go? My goodness. Guys, I had so many projects and I was moving things around. Oh, I think it's in my planner. That's where I put it. Okay. So when you get a planner like this, when you get these planners, they come with some plastic that's punched into here and the little part that hangs on the racks at Michael's. So what I did was I took that and I just cut the hang tag off and used just the plastic. It's already pre-punched. It's ready to go. And now I've got divider. I was trying to find the actual piece of it. I have one handy. I had it when I was showing it, but I guess in my Vanna White showing of everything, I threw it somewhere. So it's around here. But I can show it on my Instagram if you want to check it out. But it's really just like the plastic piece that's all it is. You could get acetate and do create your own, or use some of the ones that are already created that come with your planner and customize them by adding stickers to it. But this is just something that's like super easy that you can do and just put a sticker on it.
Yeah. You can also use, I mentioned in the Q&A to people that you can also like find boxes, gift boxes and things like that, or boxes that you buy things in the store. You can buy, you find acetate plastic packaging on a lot of things.
Yeah, the ones that come on the Happy Planner thing, it's great because they're already punched for you. Like you literally can just cut a rectangle and you're done.
Yeah.
So I encourage you, don't throw those things away when you pull them off. Save them. Don't forget to save them.
That's right. Okay. Now, when you you mentioned a punch for the planner divider, I guess
that's
the same one that we were talking about, or a different one.
Well, I'm wondering if it's here. I'm like grabbing things in my planner room.
Right.
I mean, you can use this if you find. If you don't have like one of those hang tags and you want to make a divider, you could use scrap of paper. You could use anything and laminate it. You could do this. Another thing is if you don't have clear, let's say you don't have a clear sheet of plastic, you could take your laminator, your laminating sheet, and actually run it through the laminator with nothing in it. And now you'll have a clear, you know, kind of durable sheet that you could put your stickers on.
Right, and there's the question of what laminator do you recommend?
They, Michael's has some Scotch laminators, which are, they're classics. So those are heavy duty, great laminators for pretty much any kind of art project that you may have. So I definitely, that's the kind I use, is the Scotch ones that they have there.
The punch that you held up is the Happy Planner big punch.
And just explain to them about mini, classic, and big on that.
Okay, so this one, if you were making, let's say, a divider for your classic, your mini, you can make it with this one punch, or your large. It's got three different marks, which is great. Three different marks that kind of show you where to place the paper before you punch it. So let's say I'm making it for my classic, you know, I would put it right here and then just punch. So it makes it really easy to use and versatile for all of your different planners. You only need one punch. So and also when I'm doing a project, sometimes I know I made like a little insert for mine that was like, I mean, like a 4x6 size. What I do when I'm doing one that's like that, that's not a specific size, let's say I wanted to punch this, you know, this way, it's not really a size, but I want it to be able to go in my planner, I visually just look, let's see, I'm gonna put it in and center it so that I know you can, what's great is you can look right in there and see, okay, this is centered between some punches, and then go ahead and punch it. So it's, it doesn't have to be the full sheet size. You can use this to create any custom size insert for your planner.
Okay. Where did you get the sticker holders and the organization that, Michael's, I think it's one of the Michael's carts behind you that you got your sticker organized in. Yes.
Yes.
That
is the Hudson cart, and you guys, it's my absolute favorite. There's, if you don't have as much, you know, space. There's a smaller cart as well. I know those are like $29 and come in amazing colors. Like I kind of might need an extra one. Yeah, and they're on wheels. So you can roll them around when you're using it. You can pull it out with you like a little planner cart. There's also a ton of really cool organizational items. And right now, if you go into Michael's, when you walk in, that is like the first thing you see. It's like, oh, they have tons of really cool cubes and different things that you can do, as well as all of these containers that you can organize your stickers and everything in. So definitely, there's also, I've got these like washi holders as well. Yes, that was
another thing they asked about, is your washi organization.
Yes, they're drawers. So they, depending on the size you get, there's like some really long ones, which I really want those. And you, they're little drawers and they have like three rows. So you can really get a lot of washi in smaller real estate. You can fit, I don't even know, there's tons of rolls just within that small little cube space, and you can stack them as well. So it's, it makes them, I think, well, fun, they're pretty. And they're also, you can easily open a drawer and see everything. I think that's a lot of times we forget what we've got if we can't see it and it's not organized. So,
and that is one of the questions they asked. How do you keep track of all your stickers and not lose track of what you have?
Well, I mean, it's getting a little bit out of control. I'll admit that. But I love stickers. So a lot of times I try to organize them by sections. Like I have one row that is strictly seasonal. I'll have all my flower stickers kind of together. I'll have alphabet. So I'll have ones that are functional. They might be icons. It's really whatever works for you and makes sense for you. My way of organizing, you might be like, I don't use them like that. Think about how you use the stickers and put them together in groups that way. I think that's probably the best way to do it. I also take stickers, for example, I love colorful boxes and I use them all the time. I will pull them out of any book. I will pull all the boxes out and create a clamp and keep them together. So just use it the way it makes sense for you.
Absolutely. Okay, then, what is your Instagram and how do people find you outside of this class?
Yes, my Instagram handle is Mom and a Girl with Plans. And on YouTube, I'm Marielle, Mom and a Girl with Plans. And you can find me on both platforms, and I'll be sure to like show some of these. And if you have any questions about the class or anything that I've shown or want more details, just message me. Also, just wanted to give you guys a heads up that Nita, Neatly Planned, is also teaching a planner basics course. So if you're new to planning or you just want to get back to basics and really learn from someone who does amazing functional and decorative planning, be sure to check that out tomorrow at 3:00, same time, and sign up for her class as well. And if you want to watch any of these classes, because I know I went fast. So if you want to watch them again, they will be available on the Michael's website to rewatch as well on their YouTube channel.
Right, that's exciting because we have over like 24 classes now on michaels.com classes that you can go back and watch. A lot of different material has already been shown. There were questions that I think people could find some more information on if they go back and look through our.
Yes. And if you, I do have on my YouTube channel a playlist, which is all of the Michael's classes that I've done. So you can watch all of them and see them. They're all organized there as well.
That's great. All right. Well, I think that's pretty good. I think great. You answered most of the questions, but you might get some communication
yes.
on Instagram.
No problem. I know I talk fast and I go quick. I'm just really excited about all the different options. So just remember, use things different scale, save the excess pieces. Look, I've got a whole other option I can do with these. And I can't wait to see what you guys create. If you create fun stuff, be sure to tag me. I'd love to see it.
Thank you, Marielle.
Thank you guys. And I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Thanks so much for joining.
Bye.